So I'm Giorgio Metta from the Italian Institute of Technology. I head the iCub project, which is a human robotics project in the domain of robotics, artificial intelligence, and future robots. I'm working on, well, a bit the entire design and realization of robots, and in particular robots of humanoid shape. The iCub is our main product, our flagship, but also we're evolving towards more commercial-like robots on one hand, and to new high-performance robots for research on the other hand. I started as as a kid, reading science fiction books and programming computers, and then studied electronic engineering. I did a PhD in robotics, postdoc in robotics, and then I became a research assistant and lecturer and professor, and then I moved to IIT, where I'm now director of the iCub project. Passion for the work I do. This vision that I think may date back from the time I was at the university, where I started exploring computer vision when I was still an undergraduate student. And especially this feeling of machines that are autonomous, that is quite a powerful one, seeing that the robot can actually react to what you do automatically and can do certain things autonomously. It's quite a powerful view, and it's a bit of a dream, mixture of dream and excitement for the development of technology, be it always as the state of the art and looking into the future. Seriously, it's a fairly serious question. Robots may actually be a game changer in the technology, a bit like the computer was, a bit like the telecommunication devices were. And I think robotics may be the next one. There are many signs that are pointing at that direction, so it may be that people in the future will have to do less manual work, because there will be automation to do that, robots to do that type of work, but there's still the creation of a lot of new jobs. I mean, people developing the apps for robotics, for instance. I mean, all these robots will have to be developed. I mean, the AI won't be ready for a long time in a general sense. Building a machine that can learn anything from scratch is simply not feasible at the moment, so I will imagine a situation where we had a lot of people developing very smart applications for robots that are moderately intelligent, but not fully intelligent. And so it still requires people to actually do the programming. Again, it depends whether we're talking at a philosophical level or if we're talking about, the concrete, what's happening now. So philosophical level, who knows, because it may take thousands of years before actually we manage to get to understand intelligence to a level that will make possible this general type of intelligence as humans do. At the practical level, I believe that what we're gonna do is machines that are in part autonomous, but most of the time will be programmed by people or controlled by people, which means that there will be new problems, like understanding who's responsible for a robot that misbehaves. But not that the robot is taking initiative, simply that is, as any other device that was built by humans, accidents may happen. So that type of understanding requires some reasoning about do we need to fear that, or simply it's going to be helpful as anything else. I mean, the same happened, automation happened in factories, there are accidents from time to time, but it's still, you know, a lot safer to use automation. It's happened in airplanes. Again, there may be accident due to automation, but most of the time it's human accidents. And the same will be true maybe for the automotive industry next, and the future will be autonomous robots. But again, I don't think we'll have to fear per se the technology. It's gonna be mostly how it's used and whether the regulations will come to actually use it. And there's a nice view of this, which I think is kind of interesting. At the time, Gary Kasparov was defeated by Deep Blue in the famous, you know, chess game. He sort of mentioned the fact that he was fighting an intelligence that was smart but not quite human. And so my feeling is that we, at a certain point, we'll get artificial intelligence that is going to be different from humans and will be sort of artificial intelligence plus human intelligence doing much better than just the two separate. And so I feel more like it would be an improvement of human possibilities because there's this cooperation. Again, depends on, I think we don't know what consciousness is in humans. We know that it exists because everybody feels it, but it's always a first person perspective. It's difficult to measure objectively from outside because scanning the brain at that level is super almost impossible at the level that is needed to understand what's going on. And so in principle, there's no reasons for thinking that we won't be able to duplicate what is about the brain that makes consciousness, but it's gonna be difficult to actually measure. So I understand by similarity, I think people are conscious because I feel that I'm conscious, but measuring that was gonna be difficult. For other robots will be the same. You will see a robot that behaves super well and you may think there's something behind, but who knows whether that's true consciousness. So the need for human robots comes in many phases or many facets. We need human robots because robots then interact with people in human populated environments, it's much better to have a human shape or a shape that allows to reuse the environment that has been designed for humans without changing it. I mean, one of the things they failed in home automation is the fact that you basically had to redesign the entire home if you want to automate it to a certain level. You cannot redesign all possible human spaces just because you're introducing robots, so it's much better to have a human shape. The other thing is that this has been demonstrated, people are much better at interacting with machines that move like humans. They're more predictable and they give a level of confidence that is much higher compared to what you can get from a generic machine. So even an industrial robot that can actually have eyes, so shows where it's looking, gives a much better performance when interacting with a person than a robot that simply doesn't say what's happening. So if you just see an arm but you don't know where the robot is paying attention to, that's more difficult to manage for people. So this has been shown and therefore justifies the introduction of human robots. As a space passionate, I would like to see people, but given the difficulties, it's more likely there's gonna be 100,000s of robots going in space and not that many people going in space. It's easier simply. I mean, robots can be built to be space proof, while people are people. So the life support that is needed is a little more difficult to build. For the space exploration, realistically, it could be that you send the robots and you keep you know, the people nearby Earth, which is not so exciting though. In terms of the cooperation, you know, robotics will be everywhere, because imagine going to Mars. It will be, and there are actually plans, or at least sketches of plans, sending the robots first, building infrastructure automatically, and then sending people. And that's actually a possibility, you know, sending the automation first, preparing space, and then people will arrive. And so that would be the type of cooperation. Also, there can be stricter cooperation as anywhere else. I mean, robots can interact with people, take care of some of the jobs that are more difficult or more dangerous for people. So why not? I mean, the people would be better stay inside rather than going outside and doing AVAs or whatever is needed. Short answer, nothing. Long answer, we need to be aware that this may be a powerful technology, and so this may have a social impact and also a concrete impact of possible misuse. Unfortunately, I mean, history has been telling us of so many misuses of absolutely super nice technologies, so it's mostly to be afraid of people, not of robots. To be passionate about work, and it's hard life, and there's a lot to do. I mean, especially initially in studying and being accurate and be, you know, putting a lot of effort, more than is needed, you know, to get the best possible preparation. And then I'm pretty sure if you're good enough after your initial studies, because you put effort, not because it comes for free, then you can certainly find the job that you like. I mean, it's not impossible. And I mean, when I started university, I didn't think of, you know, doing human robotics this way. But it sort of felt natural along the way to always go after the dream rather than just finding, you know, sort of an easy way to a safe job. So the research and going further also requires taking a few risks. Nothing dramatic. I mean, I never starved, or I never had serious problems finding a job, but I always tried to go for the dream. So I moved to US for a period because I thought it was there was the best possible job there. And then I came back to Europe in spite of everybody maybe staying in the US, because I was starting a human robot project that I really liked, which is the iCub. So it's also following your dreams and the possibilities that are certainly available. I mean, and this is a good period for technology related, you know, opportunities. To work in technology is very easy.